Ben Simmons and Lonzo Ball, two rookies making early cases for Rookie of the Year considerations, but both in very different ways. And we are here to break it down. Welcome to Give and Go. I'm Madelyn Burke, joined by Jared Zwerling and DeAntae Prince. Guys, first of all, Lonzo. Earlier on, he was kind of getting a lot of hype, a lot of preseason hype. People were saying that this guy should be Rookie of the Year. This guy should save basketball in the Lakerland. But, you know, obviously it's been great before. He wanted to bring him back to the promised land. He's been doing pretty well so far this season. What do you like from him?
Well, I like that even though he's dealing with these shooting struggles, he's still controlling the team. He's still controlling the tempo. He's still getting them into their sets. He's getting other guys involved, and he's not letting the fact that he can't hit a shot from anywhere get in the way of, you know, his psyche. Although there have been a couple times where it's like the memes that show that his body language is getting a little bit out of whack, and that's right. One of those clear signs of whether a guy has confidence or not.
Right.
But aside from those little spats, I think he's just like keeping his head up even though he's not shooting that well.
It's almost though he's shooting over 30% or under 20%, but there's not really any of those medium games for Lonzo, but he does have a lot of impact on the court whether or not he's filling up the stat sheet.
Madelyn and DP, I've been so impressed off the court, his brother in China, the incident there, LeVar Ball, all the comments in the media, the big ball of
LeVar
brand.
Ball about to get in the WrestleMania ring with the POTUS over this. Like, yeah. This is a possibility.
I know, he's on CNN tonight, actually, at 10.
Yeah,
I heard.
That's
about
the
Donald Trump comments, but all the distractions. His focus in interviews is so good, keeps his answers pretty short. He's very locked in and focused on the court as well. I think playmaking. You know, Lakers are a very young team, and obviously he has to come in and control that environment. A lot of young guys obviously have different focuses off the court, building their brands, but he's trying to get this team locked and loaded. His pick and roll playmaking is pretty good. His passing is very good. Two triple doubles so far this year. Shooting, as you guys know, very dismal right now, but he has to control this team. I think in transition, he's great. He's finishing at the rim with a lot of energy and excitement. His shooting will come along. Look, you think about the rookies in the NBA, John Wall coming in, a lot of young guys. They weren't great shooters. That's going to come with time. But I think as a guy coming in and controlling the team, I think he's doing a pretty good job.
Well, and also the assist. That's something that you got to really point out, too. He moves the ball. He sees the ball movement very well. He's got a little bit of a pistol peek kind of to him with that. He's, what, top 10 in the league in assists, which is impressive for a guy as young as he is. Ben Simmons, on the other hand, though, this guy with the asterisk rookie year, he sat out all last season, and now he's having his first NBA season. He's playing well, too. He's getting some triple doubles. He's getting some excitement going alongside Joel Embiid and the Illadelph. I mean, Ben Simmons is, right? is he somebody who's going to really continue to maintain this throughout the regular season?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, he has sort of like go-to moves that you can see him pulling off where, you know, we talked about this a little bit earlier. He goes left and he comes back to that right-hand floater. It's pretty much unstoppable. 6'10". He can, you know, offensive rebound, push people out of the way and get in there on the glass. And
6'10 point guard, pretty
exactly.
much.
Like, and he's picking people apart because he can see over every point guard. I mean, I don't really see any signs of him slowing down. The obvious concern, the same with Lonzo, was that his shooting might get in the way. But I think the 76ers have been creative enough so that he's, you know, in the corner or he's coming off a screen and he's not necessarily in a position where defenders can sag off him, and that can become a problem.
His game is so different than Lonzo's in many ways, and a lot of it is because of Joel Embiid. You have a big man center. Mm-hmm. Joel's not going to run the court in transition, so Simmons has to control the half-court set a lot differently than Lonzo. Both are not great shooters right now, both getting their points in the paint, things like that, dishing around the paint. But, you know, Simmons, his post-up move is really separates him. DP, you talked about that, going left, finishing right, mm-hmm. both using both hands. He has the push shot, the floaters, mm-hmm. Very creative game. His bounce passes are very good, really doing a great job seeing the lanes on the court, different angles like that. So it's impressive to see. You know, another thing, too, that he has over Lonzo, he had a whole year with these guys, even though he wasn't playing off the court, chemistry building, in the practices, film sessions. So he had a chance to really build chemistry in different ways. So obviously another advantage there.
Yeah, and chemistry is key. Ben Simmons also, he's not a three-point shooter, but he's 0-for-7 from three from the season. And yeah, all of those are half-court chucks or like big heaves, like not your actual threes. But, you know, we'll see if he could get into that three-point shooting rhythm as he gets more comfortable on the court.
Yeah, another thing you mentioned with Embiid that helps Simmons, just the gravitational pull of having a guy who can score 40 points. So for Simmons, if you're on one side of the court and Embiid's on the other, I mean, you pretty much have like a lot of room to work with.
I think it's fair to say, though, that Sixers fans are definitely trusting the process with what they're seeing.
Oh, for sure.
They're selling out games now. We haven't seen they're selling out games. I mean, the Warriors game, obviously, a lot of buzz there. I mean, it's amazing. Brett Brown, you know, this guy had these teams that were winning 15 games, under 20 games, and now he's got some guys to really work with. Markelle Fultz is not even back yet. So another guy to really watch to see how they're going to monitor him. So, you know, they have a lot of young guys that are really making some unique impacts in different ways.
It's a long play out in Philly. It's a long play, but we'll see how it pans out as the season unfolds. Continue to check out the crossover on SI.com/NBA for all your latest on and off the court.